Welcome back to Let's Interactively Play Sorcery, Steve Jackson Sorcery. I'm the RPG Chick, and once again, we only had two votes on the last video, both for two different things. Really need more votes, guys? Is anyone else out there not voting? Pleased to be voting. So, a roll of 1 to 2 will be going back to Shinva's tomb and trying to deal with the monstrosity that lurks there, and 3 and 4 will be heading back towards the north gate, as seen at the end of last episode. Let's see what we get. Back to the north gate, it is. Okay. We're just going to retrace our steps, basically. Seeing this. To the right, a massive shadow form, so large it seems as though a colossus has seated itself on the wall in thought. A chill wind blows through you as though ghosts walk back and forth this way. I want to go to the right. Oh, the ziggurat. Okay, it's just a ziggurat. So I'm going to deal with this. Okay, let's try this, since now I actually have gold pieces. Let's drop in a gold piece to this gargoyle, which I hadn't done last time. You slide a gold piece into the gargoyle's mouth. For a moment, nothing happens, then it appears to swallow. And next, it opens its stone eyelids to reveal two crisp and beautiful eyes. Do they look like human eyes? Now again, you got the rest of the text I wasn't reading because we've been here before. Looking into the gargoyle's eyes fills you with a sense of calm and peace. The eyes close after a moment, but the sense of well-being remains. Or did you just imagine that the gargoyle moved? Keep going, which makes me lose a point of stamina. Watch the torches. You guys can pause the video if you want to read this. We've been through this now. I hope you guys can hear the cats. That's why I made that sound. There were cats in the background. So I lost another point of stamina. I'm gonna enter. I don't know what's at the top, but I want to, Alright. We end up fighting this damn thing. It lifts up. I'm gonna defend again. Yeah, that was a... ooh. Crap. I think I'm gonna do this over. Gotcha. Rough going. Gonna try again. It didn't hit me that hard the first time, so I'm gonna cut. Oh! What? It's not hard to defeat. I'm just trying to like, end with more than 4 stamina. Bum, bum, bum. Shameful. Even worse. See? Randomly. Six stamina, I'll take it. Avoid the circles. So again, we've been through all this. What happened? Wait, what? What'd it say? I can't visit the statue? What? Is it gonna show me the... I went too fa- Yeah, it's not available, apparently. We can't do this over again. Let's climb for the top then. Disappointing. You turn back to the steps and climb higher, all the way to the top of the ziggurat. I don't think we've been up here. Night has fallen. Stars spread across the sky in a peaceful repose that belies their true nature. Warring spirits tussling for control of the world below. Look at the view. I think we have been up here, actually. Look at the stars, and I got to make a new spell, right? What's the new spell? Did I write it down? I think I wrote it down somewhere, I just don't know where. Oh, tack, right. Attack was like fireflies and sparkles. Should I do that or try for something else? What about purr? We don't have a purr, do we? P-E-R. We have pep, which is super strength. Pop, which is exploding pebbles. We might not get anything. Try purr. Actually, let me look back. T. Tur. Tar. Trying to guess from, like, what it... Because the three letters will often give an indication of what it is. So we only got T, L, and P. L. So we got... A, E, and U. Lar, lack. Eh. Let's go for purr. I don't know what that would be. Unknown. Cast. You attempt to raise a spell that does not exist, and you suffer the harsh consequences as the magic collapses around you. It is more than you can take. I die? You have been consumed by magic. Well, how do I know it doesn't exist? I'm trying to make a new one. Okay. So what about... Peck. Purr and peck, there's nothing. How about... Par. Anything like that, right? I'm gonna go back to my old one. I still know what it is, don't I? Disappointing we can't go in, like, can't talk to the Korga again. I get attacked by werewolves. How did I get past them again? You wait as once again the werewolves emerge from the trees to surround you. The man controlling them steps out last of all. Who goes there? He demands. Friend or foe? Friend. The man does not respond. It is clear he is waiting for something. But for what? I know Vic. The man raises an eyebrow. I hear he's a dangerous man, he said slowly. Watching your expression as he speaks. Is this a code? Am I supposed to say something back? Other than just say that's true, but honorable. If he were here, that might mean something, the man replies. A pulsing vein at the man's temple gives away his fear. Perhaps he has never killed before, but with a swift movement of his hands he gestures to his dogs. They bound forward, two catching your wrists and slavering jaws, holding them tightly but firmly. One flick of my finger, he says, his voice shaking, and you'll never lift so much as a fork again. Now give me a straight answer. Are you with us or against us? I am with you. Then tell me the passphrase, the man replies, before I'm forced to take the throat of a friend. Cast a spell. Can I cast a spell with both my hands bound like that? Guess we're gonna find out. How about invisible wall? Nope, not an option. kind of makes sense in this case, you know. These would maybe be the spells that you don't need to gesture to bring into being. Force field? No. We got P, G, and T, and H, and D. What about the spell I just made? Will it scare them? Tech? Nope, I don't have it. I have TE. TE, what is... Oh, read mind. Well, it's not gonna help me get out of this. It will if it tells me what the thing is. Ah. Wait, yeah, that's right. I used to have the skull cap. I lost it, right? It was stolen by the friggin' gnome or whatever it was. Let me pass. The city is not free tonight, the man says, shaking his head. Things are changing. I don't know it. So, you're a late recruit to our cause. Well, it isn't too late. The fee to join us is... He pauses a moment as he sizes up what you're worth. For you, 33 gold pieces. I don't have that much. Well, doesn't he take all our gold then? The man looks at you for a long moment, trying to decide if you're trying to lie to him. Finally says, then I'll take your money pouch. I have 4 stamina. It's a bold thing to say. You are outnumbered, caught fast, and the man looks desperate. He's sweating hard now. I will do that, he insists. I do not want to, but I will do it. You spit on his boots in reply. The man nods. Very well, then. You do not see the gesture he makes, but it is too fast, but you see its consequence. From all sides, the wolves spring, and suddenly your vision is a mess of fur and blood and teeth. You have been torn apart by werewolves. Okay. Friend? Alright, let's try a spell that actually could work. Now I can maybe cast Fireball? If I choose psychic info, nope, we don't have that option. We don't have how. What's the other one? Detects trap. SUS? We don't have S. Alright, fireball. Look at me, almost out of stamina. You try to raise the spell with it with your hands firmly gripped, ripped firmly by the werewolves. You cannot cast anything. The man is waiting for your answer. Yeah. That's the only way, is to let him take all our money? God, we finally have money. Try to run. You break instantly into a run, pelting down the path as fast as you can. Okay, so we're running away. We're running towards the North Gate, not away from it. I thought they were, like, ahead. Something begins to chase you in the dark, but you hear another voice calling it back. After a few more strides, you fall back to a walk. The north gate is in sight once more, and the wolves in the trees are behind you. Okay. I think we're going to rewind again. If I can. You have reached the north gate once more. The ground is empty still. The goblins have not yet risen. Off to one side is a well, but there is no other cover. Wasting no time, you stride over to the gate. Yes, we do. You reach the other side of the clearing unscathed and stand below the enormous doors. You haul at the door. The gate does not even rattle. You hear a scrabbling noise in the distance. Recite the spell. Tumblers too sealed deep inside. By Korga's grace and something's pride. Klaatu Barada Nukta! You stand back to see what effect the lines, your lines have had. The voice has gone silent. You look around towards the well. It is crawling with figures, long claws and flashing swords, and hunched bodies scrabbling in the dirt. Goblins! It looks like the army under the city have chosen this moment to attack. Then the voice booms out. Incorrect! The door is sealed! The rest of it plays out exactly as you recall. In the midst of the bloodshed, the ghost appears, beckoning to you. And we approach Lorag again. Yeah, I don't have everything. It seems you were unsuccessful. The wizard remarks. Will you try again? Are you willing to give up the search now? Continue the search. I will try again, you tell him. This time, the wizard advises, choose your path with care. Once again, the wizard begins to spell, and you feel yourself drawn into the air. All right. Upper Kharé. Haha. Oh, drink from the fountain. Nice. Drinking from a fountain give you back 5 stamina. Can we drink again? No, I didn't read this. The second time is no more pleasant than the first. The pain builds and then you explode outwards, teeth and skull and limbs flying in all directions. The city port below looms large, swallowing you like a dark mouth. And then you are awake again. The sun is rising over the streets of Upper Kharé. A few creatures roam this way and that, unaware that they have walked these streets in just this fashion once before. In one corner, a spring bubbles with fresh water. You cup your hand to the water and drink a mouthful. It is fresh and invigorating, as though the water was enchanted. Look around. Looking left, the road heads through into a residential area that seems well cared for. A short way off to the right is an open plaza. You stop a passing creature. Excuse me, I need to ask you. The creature's head is bowed, and it doesn't look up, but it pulls itself free and hurries away. It is too miserable to speak. There's nothing for it. You will have to explore for yourself. Have I been here? Oh no, I've been over here. I think I'm supposed to go... Yeah, I don't want to go towards Fireview Square. I'm afraid I won't be able to go back. Alright, hold on. I actually see something. You turn right, heading away from the city wall. A sign points towards Fireview Square. You pass large houses and have the aspect of official places of business. One is marked with the clawed fist of a moneylender. An elven woman is just leaving. She looks quite worn out already, this early in the morning. You stop the woman with a gesture. She looks up at you in surprise. What is that building? You ask. The woman looks at you in some surprise, as though she thinks your question must be a joke. It's a moneylender's, she replies. Though why they call themselves that, I don't know. She gulps back a sob. They've turned you down? She looks at you, her narrow eyes wide. Oh, stranger, she moans. You have no idea. I will help you, you declare. She pulls a face. You? Why would you do that? I cannot pay you, as I'm sure you can guess. I'm an adventurer. She takes a step back. Yeah, I remember this. I've had enough adventurers for one lifetime, thank you. Always the same with adventurers. Every day a new adventure. I have to be going. Wait. She steps away, then stops, looking at you expectantly. She wipes a tear from her eye. Maybe you'll need a guide? That would be useful. I don't need any of that. I just want to see. I want to see if I can go to she remembers an apology and heads down to the street. I want to see if I can go to Fireview Square. I remember talking to these people before. I want to see if we can get some rations and head back. Herbalist. What about the herbalist? Maybe I can go there after. If I can't head back, we need to go north, but... Four gold pieces. One glistening bomba fruit. You hand over four gold pieces and the vendor takes the bomba fruit and drops it into your arms. It is heavy, but smells ripe, and the flesh is usually excellent. I had a friend, he remarks, who ate five of these a day. Never got ill, but then he never got out of the privy either. I need to find the spell lines. For the North Gate, you tell him. The vendor laughs. You're going to get your head cut off, going around saying that to people. He pauses to rearrange his fruit, accidentally sticking his thumb through a moldy plum as he does so. Where do you get your fruit? I know about the undead. I have money. I might as well use it before werewolves take it or something. Back up this way. I don't think we've been over here, because we went south before, I think. You make your way up the alley, only to find it is blocked about halfway along by a colossal slick of what looks like vegetable waste. The slimy mass pours out of a large warehouse building as though someone has allowed a spell of soup-making to get out of control. You approach boldly. As you get closer, you start to see that the green, slimy mess is very gently inflating and deflating. It is breathing, and very, very big. You back away once more. There was no way past the thing, whatever it is. Ah! Take a side alley. Why wouldn't you be barking at me? You make your way between the buildings on the right side of the road. Little soup blob thing. Slipping around the side of a high wall until you emerge onto a wider street once more. To your left, a line of buildings has been constructed out of the side of a natural cliff face. Above them is a thick area of trees. On the right is a walled area you found your way around to get here. Wherever it is. Well, whatever it is. Look into the trees. Did you see something move between the pines that line the ridge? You stop and stare, but make out nothing. Perhaps the movement of a low shadow, but perhaps it is the sunlight through the shifting branches. But certainly those trees must be thick with wild animals, and the creatures that live here must be plagued by them, unless the creatures that live here are more dangerous themselves. Look at the high wall. Turning about, you crane your neck to look at the wall. To look at wall. It is several times your height. Whoever lives here is keen to keep the inhabitants of Kharé out, or keen perhaps to keep whatever is inside in. The surface is rough and pockmarked with age. At the very top, something gleams. Ooh, really? Climb the wall? Am I going to lose more stamina? You feel over the stones for decent hand and footholds, and then, checking both ways to make sure no one is watching, you begin to scale the wall. But it is high, and about halfway up you realize you are tiring, but you are too high to simply drop down. Whatever it is on top of the wall glints, still several moves from where you are. Keep going. Oh my god! I just lost 4 stamina. You keep going, ignoring the burning in your arms and legs. Once you reach the top, you will be able to rest, but in your final reach, you put one hand up for the top of the wall and cry out with pain. It seems the gleam you saw from the street is a rack of metal spines designed to stop people climbing up. Blood dribbles down your arm, and worse, the shock makes you let go, and you fall to the ground painfully. It seems whatever is behind that wall is going to stay behind it. Giant form. Should've done that in the first place. Hopefully it's something that will give me a lot of stamina. The notorious B-I-I-G. Back to 4 stamina. You cast the spell, inflating from your boots to your neck until you are 3 times your normal size. You are now about as high as the wall itself. Look at the gleam. You peer down at the gleam on top of the wall. It is a small yellow jewel. Not gold, and probably not valuable. Well, I'm taking it. You pick it up anyway to find it is a sun jewel. This is an extremely lucky find. Sun jewels are rare and highly valuable. You drop it carefully into your pack. Then the spell fades, and you shrink back down to your normal size, the wall towering above you once again. Sun jewel. Do we have something like that? A spell we can cast with a sun jewel? I have a jewel-studded medallion. Sun jewel. Oh, light spell. S-U-N. Cool, got a light spell. You nurse your wounded arm and move on. Oh, but I want to be up there, don't I? Oh, shut up. You follow the road as it narrows. The houses built up against the cliff face become narrower, too, with single buildings divided and divided again, until each dwelling is no wider than its own doorway. Damn. Must be crowded. Knock on a door. You pause to knock on a random door. After a short pause, it opens to reveal a thin woman wearing a bright blonde wig. She seems surprised to see you. Who are you? She demands. Who sent you? I'm from the council. From the council? She yelps. Why ever? I pay my bills. I'm an honest Finn, me. I know, that's why I'm here. She narrows her already narrow eyes. What is it you want? Oh, I need somewhere to stay? I need somewhere to stay. She shakes her head. Things with the council have got that bad, have they? Well, don't say we didn't all warn you. She folds her arms. Damn, I need stamina. You thank her for her time. It's been a long time since we've been able to stay somewhere. Now Now, I know I have one ration. I'm trying to save it for when I absolutely need it. You turn down a side alley past large houses on either side. On the left, you can just make out the roof of a mansion, from which a tattered flag is flying. What mansion? The pennant is blue and gold and bears a crest, depicting stars shining above an open book. When the wind catches the flag and lifts it, you can briefly make out a letter in black along the near edge. An L, perhaps? L. Like Valorag? Turn back and head for the mansion. Intrigued, you turn back up the alley towards the flag. Okay, an L. He's the ghost we found, isn't it? Magical items. We do have the skull cap. Isn't that what I just tried to cast and it didn't work? The thought thing? To read thoughts, T-E-L? Requires a skull cap. Just by rewinding, I have it again? I'm so confused. I guess I didn't have it until I rewound again. I don't know if I know. The road turns and heads roughly southeast once more, but you have been spotted. A group of young orklings are scurrying towards you. Hurry to avoid them? You increase your stride, hoping to breeze straight past, but the gang is big enough for them to easily block the road. You are soon right in their midst. Their hands poke at you and push outwards, hoping for a donation. Throw a gold piece away so they go run for it, and then I can go, right? You toss a gold piece away down the street. The orklings fall about themselves immediately, squabbling over it. Do I dare try to talk to them? You catch one of the orklings by the arm. Now I get something from you. The orkling gulps. I'm not ready to go to North Gate yet. Have you heard of a man called Vic? The orklings shake their heads. No. The orklings squabble and shove one another aside. Might as well ask. The orkling looks at you very seriously. I'll tell you, he says, for one gold piece. Never mind. You laugh. I'm sure you'd say anything for a gold piece. The orkling shrugs and starts sucking at his thumbnail, eating the dirt underneath. Yummy! You swat away a little orkling whose hand has mysteriously found its way into your backpack. It took gold! You gently move the orklings aside so you continue along the path, but despite your gift, the little creatures are crowding in close, their hands mauling at your backpack. They're trying to steal from you. Get off me or curse your souls, you declare. The orklings back off a step. One chews his lip with an oversized tooth. Have I got a soul then? He asks his friend. How much would it fetch? The little pests hang back a little, giggling and shoving at each other. Take my leave of them. You bow to little creatures and take your leave of them. They smile and snigger and wave as you go. It seems you have quite charmed them. Am I missing items? I have that. I have those. It looks like I just took some... Still have my ration. Keys. Alright, I need to get to this mansion. You continue up the road, leaving the chattering orklings behind. After a short distance, you come across a large building made of stone and mortar. It stands alone inside its own patch of grounds, and, unusually, it seems to be in a state of good repair. A large L is carved on one gatepost. For Lorag, perhaps? The main road continues straight past the house. Oh, we're going to the house. You enter the gate and follow the path to the front of the house between tall, well-tended trees. This place seems quite lived in. So we can go to the front door or creep around the side. I feel like taking my ration, just... Bumba fruit. Okay. Need to find more rations soon. Front door. The door to the house is solid oak wood, decorated with elaborate carvings of vines and trees. And serpents. In the middle is a great brass knocker. Knock, knock, knock. You rap three times. After a short wait, an elderly man in a gown opens the door, with a strange spiky lizard creature winding around his legs. Yes? He demands. And who are you? You look like a trustworthy sort. Okay. Gonna leave it here. What do you think? What do you guys think I should tell him? He's an elderly man in a gown with a strange spiky lizard creature winding around his legs. Should I say I'm a sorcerer like you? Or I'm just a traveler? I'm a great warrior? Or I'm from the council? You know how well that worked last time, saying we were from the council? Who knows? It might work this time. So let me know what you guys think. Hopefully more than two people will vote. And I see you guys next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.